Okay, rock on, rock on. Today is day 90 of the Momentum Challenge with heart and mind aligned. And I hope that you will give yourself a big hand and do some kind of celebration for 90 days in the Momentum Challenge. I would love to hear in the comments what you birthed out of this 90 days. Please do not judge it. If it's small to you, maybe you cleaned your room, or if it was big to manifesting a car, winning the lottery, whatever it is, was if it was a connection, maybe you were able to connect with family members, or you learned to cook something, please celebrate yourselves in this momentum challenge. It's all because of you and you and you and you and all you. Okay, so day 90. Yes. Okay. Oh, and thank you for joining me. I am at 8. I am Maggie. I am Maggie. Okay. Angels, welcome. They're always here. Okay, we're on day 90 of the Momentum Challenge. Okay, so we're finishing up The Law of Non-Resistance, the book with Florence Shin. And she's so awesome. You can just feel her presence as we continue to work through her material. Okay, so we were on point 51. I really like point 50. So point 50 was about staying alert, awaiting leads, and taking advantage of every opportunity, right? And we take action because we are bringing it. We are the large sums of money crew. We are the crew that is just here to change the world. So, okay, 52, 52. Make this a habit, and one will see wonders and miracles come into life. What should you make a habit of? Having a morning affirmation. So I'm going to read that morning affirmation one more time because it's so much fun. A lot of you guys, you're waking up when I'm going to sleep. So you get these videos as your morning is coming. So it could be perfect. Thy will be done this day. Today is a day of completion. I give thanks for this perfect day. Miracle shall follow miracle, and wonders shall never cease. Wonders shall never cease. Miracle will follow miracle for you, and it will just continue. So stay in that vibration. Okay, so excited. All right, that's 57. So 58 looks like a story. One morning, I picked up a book and read, "Look with wonder at that which is before you." Okay, let's pick that up. Look at wonder at that which is before you. And honestly, when you just wake up every morning, when you begin to just walk through life, you do look at wonder at everything. You do look at wonder when you do look with wonder at whatever's before you. Like sometimes people they just take for granted like that babies are born. But it's such a miracle when babies are born. And sometimes those babies are preemies. Okay, so right now, we got the whole world in our hands and our heart. Let's say a prayer for all the babies around the world. We just thank you, Infinite Spirit, for these beautiful children. We just ask that your blessings, your wisdom, your love, your health, your wealth, and your ability to help light this new earth social memory complex be within these beautiful children. We ask that they be protected and everything they need be given, and that they just be the most amazing children of God. What I'm just saying, as we look at life and we look with wonder at everything that's before us, butterflies, amazing. Bees, that a bee can fly, amazing. Hummingbirds, amazing. Blue jays, amazing. The ocean, amazing. Like, all, it's all wonderful. Amazing. Okay, so 58. It seems to be the message for a day, so I repeated it again and again. So what is 58 or 59? 59 is basically look with wonder at that which is before you. So that's got a double time. That's 59 in double time. Look with wonder at that which is before you. And I can tell you right now, as I get to know many of you in our group, I look at wonder with all that is before me in each of you. Each of you are so talented and have so much to bring the world. And I am so excited to get to be a part of that. So, okay, 60. At about noon, a large sum of money was given me, which I had been desiring for a certain purpose. So she looked with wonder that was all before her, and at noon, she received a large sum of money. Isn't that wonderful? So let's continue to look at wonder for all that is before us. Okay, in a following chapter, she gives affirmations, right? And she's giving affirmations that are, so as we continue to go, I'll probably do like a video with just her affirmations. I'm learning and growing on this channel, and I'm gonna be learning a lot from Benzie Darling. And so I might be able to have meditations for you soon, but when I do, I hope to work on bring those affirmations to be Florence, to start maybe with Florence's, but we will see, because I am in the process of learning and growing. So, however, one should never use an affirmation unless it's absolutely satisfying. So she talks about how you want the affirmation to be in alignment and you want to believe it. You can't have your consciousness fighting back. And so sometimes what she's saying is you might want to pop that hood and adjust the affirmation so that it can fit. But also, we also know, just like training a muscle or like making YouTube videos and you getting better, there's sometimes you need to just work the affirmation and use, you know, the skills that you know that will help you to, like maybe writing the affirmation down so it goes in, doing it while you're asleep, et cetera, so that it fully enters the arena of your mind, your subconscious mind, and it can act. Okay, so that's 60. Okay, so 61 is, for example, the following had brought success to many. Oh, okay, sorry. This is 61, and I am in love with 61. Okay, I have a wonderful work in a wonderful way. I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. I have a wonderful work in a wonderful way. I give a wonderful service for wonderful pay. Yay, yay. So she talks about how she wrote the first two lines. I have a wonderful work in a wonderful way. I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. So she wrote the first two. I give wonderful work for, I give wonderful serve, work in a wonderful way. She wrote that. And a client of hers added, I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. Isn't that wonderful? So it made a most powerful statement, as there should always be perfect payment for perfect service, and a rhyme sinks in easy into the subconscious. So does a rhyme and a jingle. That's why sometimes when you watch commercials and you're like, ugh, why is, I got this thing stuck, a Dorito or whatever, Kool-Aid, you got whatever stuck in your head, because those campaigns, I mean, they know how to manipulate the mind, but they also know they put that jingle and that rhyme and then you get it. So she went on singing aloud and soon did receive wonderful work in a wonderful way. And she gave wonderful service for wonderful pay. Hey, hey, hey. Okay, another student, a businessman. Okay, so this is 61. For all you businesses and entrepreneurs, So she had a student who was a businessman. He took it and changed the word to business. I have a wonderful business in a wonderful way. I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. I have a wonderful business in a wonderful way. I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. Peace. Okay, and the thing is, he started working that affirmation, and that afternoon he received $41,000 in a deal that he had made. He had had no activity in that affairs for months. So, you know, when you do the work will do you. The universe will serve you up with the most amazing opportunities. And you want to just prepare. This is what we've been doing in this momentum challenge. We've been preparing the soil to be able to plant the seeds, to be able to receive the growth, to be able to receive the fruits of our labors, but also our proper thought forms. Okay, so $41,000 right now, $41,000 would be a big deal. This book is written, I don't know, it's a ways back, 1925 about. So I'm just to say, anywhere between 1925 to 1940, $41,000 was a heck of a lot of money. So if you do the work will do you. Let us all affirm that we have wonderful businesses in wonderful ways, and we give wonderful service for wonderful pay. And I would love to, I know I'm going to be hearing wonderful stories about how this wonderful opportunities and wonderful service and wonderful pay and every wonderful clients and the whole, all of it. And you'll actually be watching me as I keep trekking up the hill of business too, moving from maybe no clients to a few clients to thousands of clients to millions of clients, because I really, you know, I really see big things for me and for all of you. And we are just here large and in charge to help and serve and love one another. Okay, so 63. Every affirmation must be carefully worked and completely covered the ground. Okay, so we're going to be getting into more of that in the next chapters. So, for example, so story 64 is the story. Okay. I knew a woman who was in great need and made a demand for work. She received a great deal of work, so you got that, but was never paid. So she knew she needed to add wonderful service for wonderful pay. So make sure you are affirming, I have wonderful business in a wonderful way. I give wonderful service for wonderful pay. Let's really dig into this one. Okay, we're gonna watch the road just roll out for us. It might be a red carpet, might be rolling out for you, but whatever it is, it's gonna roll out. Roll out. Okay, it is man's divine right to have plenty, more than enough. His barn should be full and his cup should flow over. Oh my gosh, there's this wonderful teaching that I've been working with Reverend Ike, and he talks about how we are oil wells and how our cup shall always be full, that our oil well will be gushing over, that we will have abundance, not just in terms of the actual natural resource, but within us. We carry the fire of the Creator. We carry the oil of the Creator, and we are going to fill that oil up, and we are going to be flowing, overflowing with abundance and plenty, and we're going to be doing the good work that Infinite Spirit put us here to do. So, this is God's idea for man and woman. And when man breaks down the barriers of lack in his old consciousness, the golden age will be his or hers. And every righteous desire of their heart fulfilled. And so I know so many of you have these beautiful, righteous hearts that you are going out there giving your dreams and visions, acts of service, purposes, and you are just changing the world one person at a time. And I just want to thank you so much for going on this momentum journey with me. Give yourself a hand. It's day 90 in the momentum challenge. So bravo, bravo, ciao bella, love you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I cannot tell you enough. Day 90. Okay, I love you all, and I'm very grateful for you being here with me. And follow me, subscribe, like, leave your positive comments. I am very, very grateful for you. I would love to know in this 90-day momentum challenge, pew, 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 what did you knock out of the park? Or pew, 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 what did you KO? Tell me all about it. I would love to hear in the comments. And thank you so much for your love and support. And just know that big things are coming for all of us. Big things popping for all of us. All of us. Because we're all one. We're all connected. One wins, we all win. So if you are feeling like you're at the bottom of the heap, just keep chugging, because you're going to get to the top. And if you're at the top, enjoy, bask, and hold that vibrational field, because so much good is coming for you. So much good. I can't even tell you how much wonderful dreams, goals, visions, acts of service, purpose, your heart's desire are going to be fulfilled. Keep going. All right. Well, thank you for joining me. Subscribe, like, leave your positive comments. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much for supporting me. And I want to congratulate you on 90 days in this momentum challenge. Like, whoa, hugs. Oh, okay. So thank you. And you know, may you be at peace. May you be in peace. May you just be surrounded by peace. May you be a channel of peace. Yes. And love. And joy. And everything else good under the sun. So thank you. Love you. Thanks.